to remove the stand. Loosen the two Phillips No. 2 screws securing the stand to the bottom of the PC. Remove the stand from the unit. The two captured screws on the stand. Align into screw holes on the bottom of the PC. To replace the stand, align the screws over their holes and secure the screws. To remove the access panel, first remove the stand. Squeeze the latch for the rear I/O panel cover. Swing out the left side of the cover and remove the cover. Slide the green access panel latch at the rear of the unit down into the stenciled unlocked position. Slide the access panel toward the rear of the unit and lift it off of the unit. The access panel has several tabs on its inside perimeter. Let's slide into slots on the chassis. To replace the access panel, place the panel down on the chassis, slightly behind its final position. Slide the panel forward until flush against the front of the chassis. Slide the latch for the access panel up into the stenciled locked position. The rear I/O panel cover has three small tabs on the right side that fit into slots on the rear of the chassis. To replace the rear I/O panel cover, align the tabs into their slots and press the other side into place until the latch snaps into position. To remove the fan, first remove the stand if installed, and the access panel. Detach the fan connector to the motherboard. Remove the two Phillips No. 1 screws securing the fan to the motherboard. Pull the fan out of the unit. To replace the fan, place the fan back down into place over its standoffs on the motherboard, routing the motherboard connector inside its nearby screw standoff. Replace the two Phillips No. 1 screws to secure the fan to the motherboard. Replace the fan connector to the motherboard. To remove the low-profile graphics card, if installed in the unit, first remove the stand, if installed, and the access panel. Swing the green graphics card retaining latch to the stenciled unlocked position. Pull up on the PCI Express retaining latch on the graphics riser module, and carefully pull the graphics card out of its slot. To replace the graphics card, press the card into its slot on the graphics card riser module until correctly seated into its slot on the module. Swing the green graphics card retaining latch around to the locked position to help secure the graphics card in the unit. To remove the graphics riser module, first remove the stand if installed, the access panel, and the graphics card if installed in the unit. Pull out on the retaining tab at the top of the graphics riser card bracket and firmly pull up on the graphics riser module and bracket to remove the assembly from the unit. If replacing the graphics riser module, detach the two Torx 15 screws that secure it to its bracket and remove it from its bracket. To install a new graphics riser module, place the graphics riser module onto its bracket and secure with two Torx 15 screws. The graphics riser module bracket has two tabs that fit into slots on the chassis. There is also an edge at the center that rests under the retaining tab on the chassis. To replace the graphics riser module and bracket assembly, press the riser connectors into their slot on the motherboard and the bracket tabs into their slots. The retaining tab should rest on top of the middle edge of the bracket when correctly installed. To remove the M.2 flash storage drive, first remove the stand, if installed, and the access panel. Loosen the Torx 8 screw securing the M.2 drive in place. The M.2 drive will pop up. Pull the M.2 drive out of the socket. If replacing the M.2 drive, pull off the screw kit attached to the module and reserve. The M.2 drive has a notch near one of the side edges that aligns over a key in its motherboard socket. To install a new M.2 drive, press the reserved screw kit into the half-circle notch on the new M.2 drive. Angle the drive into its motherboard socket at a 30-degree angle and press down. Hold it down while tightening the Torx 8 screw to secure it to the motherboard. To replace system memory, first remove the stand, if installed, the access panel, and the graphics card, if installed in the unit. Loosen the two captive Phillips No. 2 screws for the memory cover. Lift the memory cover off of the motherboard. Gently pull out on the retaining lever located on each side of the SODIMM memory module. The module will pop up from its socket. Pull the module out of the socket. There is a small notch on one side of each SODIMM memory module that aligns over a small tab in each SODIMM socket on the motherboard. To replace an SODIMM memory module, angle the module to about 30 degrees, engaging the notch into its socket tab. Press the module down into place until the retaining levers snap into position over the sides of the module. Align the memory cover back over the memory. There are stencils indicating the fan and the USB corners of the cover for correct orientation of the cover inside the unit. Tighten the two Phillips No. 2 screws to secure the memory cover to the motherboard. To remove the speaker, first remove the stand, if installed, the access panel, the graphics card, if installed in the unit, and the memory cover. Disconnect the speaker from the motherboard. Remove the Phillips No. 1 screw for the speaker. Pull the speaker out of the unit. The speaker slides under metal guides on the inside chassis wall. To replace the speaker, align the left side of the speaker under its guides and press the bottom onto its guide. Replace the Phillips No. 1 screw to secure the speaker to the chassis wall. Reconnect the speaker to the motherboard. CMOS factory settings should be restored as a first step before replacing the system motherboard. To restore CMOS factory settings, first remove the stand, if installed, and the access panel. Remove the battery. Wait 30 seconds. Replace the battery to the motherboard. CMOS factory settings are now reset. Note that you will now need to enter system BIOS and reset the clock in BIOS after this procedure. To remove the motherboard, first remove the stand, if installed, the access panel, the graphics card if installed in the unit. And the graphics riser module. If you are replacing the motherboard, remove system memory, the fan, and the M.2 flash storage drive. Detach the rear I/O connectors from the board. Detach the speaker connector from the board. Detach the 7 Phillips number 1 screws securing the rear I/O bracket to the unit. Pull the bracket off of the unit. Detach the 6 Torx 15 screws securing the motherboard to the chassis. Tip up the rear of the motherboard and pull the motherboard out of the unit. If replacing the motherboard, remove the heatsink from the bottom of the motherboard and reserve. Place the motherboard in an anti-static bag. To install a new motherboard, first install the old heatsink to the bottom of the motherboard. Carefully tip the front edge of the motherboard into the chassis and lay the motherboard down into the unit, being careful of the speaker connector. Secure the motherboard to the chassis with 6 Torx 15 screws. Place the rear I/O bracket back onto the rear of the unit and secure with its 7 Phillips number 1 screws. Replace the speaker connector to the motherboard. Replace the rear I/O port connectors to the motherboard. To remove the heatsink, first remove the stand, if installed, the access panel, the graphics card, if installed in the unit, the graphics riser module, and the motherboard. Loosen the 4 captured Torx 15 screws. And 2 captured Phillips number 1 screws for the heatsink on the bottom of the motherboard in the order indicated by the stencils on the heatsink. Remove the Phillips number 1 screw at the radiator end of the heatsink. Before replacing the heatsink onto the motherboard, first clean off the old thermal grease from the CPU. Clean the grease from the GPU. Clean the grease from the heatsink if replacing the same heatsink into the unit. Apply new thermal grease or thermal pad to the CPU. Apply new thermal grease or a pad to the GPU. Align the heatsink carefully over the CPU and GPU. Tighten the 4 Torx 15 screws and two Phillips number 1 screws to secure the heatsink to the motherboard in the order indicated by the stencils on the module. Replace the Phillips number 1 screw at the radiator end of the module.